Hi, everyone, and thank you for joining this afternoon's webinar titled Unleashing the Power of AI, Boosting Content Marketing Productivity. My name is Chris Rotolo. I'm the program manager with McMaster Continuing Education and the program manager for marketing and digital marketing, among other programs. And I'm really pleased for my co-host for today's session. So I'd like to welcome one of our digital marketing program instructors, Emily Bailey. So before we start, I would like to acknowledge and recognize that McMaster Continuing Education is located on the traditional territories of the Mississauga and the Haudenosaunee nations, and within the lands protected by the Dish with One Spoon Wampum Agreement. I'm going to hand over to Emily. She's going to tell you a bit about what our session plan is for the day, and she's going to educate all of us. Thank you, Emily.
Thank you, Chris, for that wonderful introduction. Welcome, everyone, to our webinar today. My name's Emily Bailey. I'm very excited to be spending the next hour or so with all of you exploring the topic of artificial intelligence and how that relates to content marketing. So some points to cover today. We'll be looking at what is AI, what is the role of AI in content marketing, some tools and applications that we can use in artificial intelligence, and also some limitations. A lot of these tools are wonderful, and I'll be telling you all about them, but I'm also here to let you know that some of these tools carry risks, some of these tools carry limitations, and some human touch is needed as well. So we'll look at some pros and cons of some leading tools. There are many, many tools out there at the moment, some paid and some are free. Today, I'll focus on just a few of those and get you started perhaps on some tools that may allow you to do your work more quickly, more efficiently, and perhaps with more inspiration. So welcome again. I am an instructor at the McMaster University Continuing Education. I teach content marketing, and I am a digital marketing and AI trainer as well in my business. I'm a marketing, a member of the Canadian Marketing Association, and I'm happy to connect with all of you via LinkedIn, via Instagram, or via email if you would like. So let's dive right in. We have a short time together and I want to make the most of it. So to kick off, what is AI? So artificial intelligence, it's very buzzy at the moment. Lots of people talking about it. Lots of people excited about it. Lots of people kind of freaked out by it as well. Today we're talking about it in relation to content marketing. And basically, artificial intelligence is a machine's ability to perform the cognitive functions that we usually associate with humans and the human brain. So a lot of folks prior to the past, you know, year or so, when AI has become such a hot topic, a lot of folks have probably interacted with AI tools before without even necessarily realizing that they are AI tools. So, for example, voice assistants like Siri, like Alexa, those are founded on artificial intelligence. Customer service chatbots that you may have used on websites or perhaps on Facebook, those are also powered by artificial intelligence. So the technology has been around for a number of years, but I would say in the past 6 months to a year, there's been really an explosion in the popularity and just the sheer number of artificial intelligence tools. So today we're going to look again at a few of those, not all of them, but just a few to get you going. The tools we're exploring today are largely generative AI tools. Now, what does generative AI mean? Well, it's an AI model that generates content in response to a prompt. So a prompt would be a command or something you would type into an artificial intelligence tool, asking it to create some social media content, for example, create some brainstorming ideas for you, create perhaps an image based on those text commands that you give it. So generative AI is a form of AI that is concerned with generating new content where there was no content before. Net new content. So AI in content marketing, of course, this is a big shift. The potential of AI is massive in our particular industry. AI, of course, has the potential to change many, many industries, and that process has really already sort of begun. However, I think in digital marketing in particular, the impact of AI is quite significant. And in my business, I deal with small, medium, and large organizations across Ontario and across Canada. And a lot of those businesses are already using tools like ChatGPT, AI tools within Canva, for example, other tools as well, to create content, to speed up their productivity, to do things faster, and to automate some of those pieces of their work that they used to do sort of without the assistance of AI. So we're talking today about AI specifically in content marketing, and really some of these tools can help to create content faster, at scale, take away some of the work involved in that first draft, perhaps, allowing marketing professionals to focus their efforts on those higher level pieces, like the strategy, the creativity aspect, which at this stage, I believe AI, can help with, but can't completely take over the role of a human. So what can AI actually produce? And by the way, I'm speaking here about AI tools that are specific to content marketing. What can AI produce? Well, you can pop in the chat. I'd love to hear from you what you have used AI for. Certainly, it can be used to generate high quality content quickly. If you use ChatGPT, it's pretty fast. You type in the prompt, you ask it for what you're looking for, and you get a response very quickly. So AI powered tools can help produce blog posts or blog post outlines. AI can create images. A tool called Midjourney is quite good for that. AI can help create videos, email content, writing, email subject lines, social media posts, and much more. This is not a comprehensive list by any means. This is really just a few things that folks in the industry are using AI-powered tools to help them create. When you are in the content marketing business, there is an expectation that you will continue to create and distribute and optimize high quality content. That is the sort of name of the game. So because AI can help us to do that more quickly and more efficiently, produce more content at scale, it can really help to sort of speed up the process and again, take some of those lower level tasks off our plate. So a few tools just to get us going here. Again, there are many, many AI tools. In fact, there are AI encyclopedias out there on the internet where you can literally look up what type of AI tool you want, and it will give you a nice list of tools. So these are three, I would say, entry level. The first two would be entry level artificial intelligence tools. And these three tools you see up on the screen are quite commonly used by folks in the marketing industry. Now, if we had more time together, we could do a deeper dive into all the wonderful artificial intelligence tools out there. And if you sign up for a course in the digital marketing program at McMaster Continuing Education, you would have the opportunity to explore some of these tools in more depth. Today, we'll be focused a little bit on each of these three tools. ChatGPT is one of them. Give me a, you can raise your hand if you have used this tool before. Awesome. Good, good, good. Lots of folks using it. Grammarly is the second one. How many folks are using Grammarly? Great, great, awesome. And the third is Midjourney. Midjourney is a tool that's used to create images. So it was a tough choice to pick just three, but I went with these three because they're each a little bit different from one another. And together we can talk a little bit more about these popular AI tools. First off, these tools are mostly free. And I'll explain what I mean by mostly in a minute, but I like to give folks different options. And certainly if you are new to AI and you are just looking to learn a little more, explore, experiment, then these three can be great places to start. So we may have some folks on the call today who are just a little at the early stages of exploring AI tools, just a little bit curious. So these three are good places to start. And if you want to start experimenting today, then you can certainly do so. So ChatGPT is probably the most popular or most commonly used artificial intelligence platform as of today. If we met again in 6 months, this could be something else, right? There are lots of other tools in development. For example, Google has an AI powered tool called Bard, which is being used overseas, but it's not being used here in Canada yet. So ChatGPT at the moment is the most commonly used tool. This is September 2023. So this one is very good for beginners. And all you need is a login and you can set up your password and you're good to go. There's different versions of ChatGPT. There's the sort of basic free version, which is perfectly good. And there is a version called ChatGPT Plus, which costs about $30 Canadian a month. A little bit faster, gives you priority access during busy times. There's also now a version called ChatGPT Enterprise. And this has entered the marketplace just a couple of weeks ago. So that is geared toward businesses who are using ChatGPT at scale. The pricing is unknown at this point. They are, you know, looking to expand the use of ChatGPT across businesses, and many businesses already are using some version of ChatGPT. So, what does this tool do? Well, it can collaborate with you, it can provide assistance with brainstorming, with content creation, with research, with proofreading, with drafting content, with editing. It can create social media captions for you. It could create a social media calendar for you. It could do market research, perhaps some competitive analysis, copywriting, you know, the list goes on. Now, this is not to say that this is the best tool for all of these things and that it's going to hit it out of the park every single time. I'm here to explain that, you know, these tools are wonderful assistants, let's call them, for marketing professionals. But I want to be clear in saying that they are not meant to replace the sort of human touch. They're not meant to do all of the work for you. And I always advise folks, no matter what their position is, don't just take what ChatGPT gives you and copy paste it and distribute it. You want to read it carefully. You want to fact check it. You want to perhaps ask the tool for another iteration of your task, and sort of collaborate with the task in a sense to make sure that you're getting the best possible output or the best possible content from ChatGPT. So it's not foolproof is what I'm saying, but it can be a very useful tool. You can treat it almost like a personal assistant, if you will, in the sense that it can help you with certain tasks. It can take certain tasks off your plate, and it can certainly help you with that tricky first draft. So it can help get you going. Again, I'd love to hear from you in the chat what you've been using ChatGPT for in your work. If you're new to ChatGPT, the best way to learn, I think, is to experiment and give the tool some background information, give it some tasks, and you know, ask it to create some content for you. So that's a quick and dirty sort of rundown on ChatGPT. I'll talk a little bit more about the risks of all of these tools together. But the ChatGPT definitely is the best place to start, I think, if you are new to artificial intelligence. Like I said, it's free. It can do a wide range of tasks. And if you don't get the result you're looking for, if you don't get the output you're looking for on the first try, please keep trying. Please work on your prompts and you know, rephrase what you're asking for or give it more information by copying information and pasting it into the chatbot. You will get better results. I will confess that the first time I used ChatGPT, it had just entered the Canadian marketplace. It just became available. And I decided to try it out for myself. So I asked it to write me 5 Instagram posts, something like that. And what it produced for me, I was not that impressed with. I didn't really think it was that great. And what I didn't understand, or what I've come to sort of learn, is you really have to train the tool. So again, if we treat it like our personal assistant, you would not expect a personal assistant to know everything on the first day. Right? You need to give it more information. You need to give it background information, and you need to write your prompts or instructions in a way that's very clear and very specific. So the more instruction you can give to ChatGPT, the better your results are going to be. So that's why I always say experiment, get curious, play around with the tool when you're not on a deadline, when you have some extra time. And that can often be the best way to learn. So the next tool I'd like to speak about is Grammarly. So how many of you have used Grammarly? Again, it's free. There is a premium version, which is paid. So let's call it a freemium tool. It's free at the beginner level, and then you can upgrade. I see some hands raised. Excellent. This is primarily a writing tool or a writing assistant, and it is powered by artificial intelligence. And what I quite like about Grammarly is that you can use it across pretty much any platform that you would be writing content on. So if you are a professional content marketer, chances are you're doing a lot of writing, right? You're creating content in you know, Instagram or in Facebook, or you're creating emails. You are perhaps writing blog posts, you're corresponding with your colleagues in writing. There's a lot of different things happening that involve writing. And writing is a very important piece of content marketing. Your writing, no matter what it is intended for in terms of its channel or its platform, it must be catchy. It must be engaging, it must be clear, and it must be concise. those are the sort of expectations, you could say, of online audiences. And we cover this in more depth in our courses here at McMaster. So this this Grammarly tool checks for your spelling, your grammar, and so on, but it's more than just a spell check, right? You can install the Grammarly plugin in your web browser if you choose. By the way, all of these tools are highly optional. I'm here to, you know, talk to you about them and give you suggestions. You don't have to do anything you're not comfortable with. However, I like to use the Grammarly plugin because when I'm writing content in my Gmail, if I'm writing content in Google Documents, in social media platforms, on LinkedIn, et cetera, it is popping up on the side of my window and it's suggesting improvements while I write. Okay, so it's not sort of waiting till the end when I've finished drafting something and giving me suggestions then. It's doing it in real time. It'll offer recommendations in terms of style and tone. And I'm a fairly skilled writer. I've been in the marketing industry for 15 years. I've done lots of writing for clients over the years, but that doesn't mean that my writing can't be improved. I'm always learning, and I find that this tool gives me some very useful recommendations, some pertinent recommendations, and will often suggest ways to make my writing stronger and better. So what I like about it is if you like the suggestions, you can click them and it instantly updates it for you in whatever platform you're writing in. You don't have to think too much about it. If you don't like the suggestions, that's okay. You don't have to take them. They're just sort of there operating in the background. So that's what I like to do with the plugin. The Grammarly tool pretty much integrates with any type of writing platform, wherever you may be creating content. And like I said, whether it's an email, whether it's a blog post, whether it's a LinkedIn post or some other tool, it's there working away, giving suggestions on how your writing can be improved. It will also catch spelling or grammar errors, which is a bonus because, you know, if you're typing fast, errors can happen. But overall, I think because copywriting is such an important part of content marketing, this tool can help to strengthen people's writing. Copy.ai is also a good writing tool that's powered by artificial intelligence. Any folks here use copy.ai? That's a good one. Also, jasper.ai is a very strong tool. Jasper.ai is typically more used by bigger organizations because it does cost a fair bit. Grammarly, like I said, is free and it can be a great place to start for content marketers. So this is an example. I took a screenshot the other day. I was writing a post on my LinkedIn account. And as you can see here, the little Grammarly sort of window opens up and I can close it if I want to, but I usually let it sort of operate in the background. And then it can help to set my voice. So if I want it to write in a certain style or tone that is particular to my own sort of brand voice, then I can get it to do that. And again, that's that AI piece that's being used in the background. It can also, as you can see on this screenshot, give you ideas. So generating ideas for a post, posing a question, sharing industry trends. I can use those little prompts to get Grammarly to do a little bit more of the work for me if I feel like it. There's lots of tools within this app that you can explore. Grammarly Go is a fairly recent sort of upgrade or addition to the Grammarly tool. Anyone here use Grammarly Go? Again, totally optional, but with Grammarly, along with all of these other artificial intelligence tools, the developers are constantly adding new features. They're constantly developing more offerings. And a lot of these tools are under development constantly. So you'll see a lot of additives or added features as time goes on. Let's talk about Midjourney. This is a tool that's used to create images. So it's maybe something I'm going to go out on a limb here and say artists may not be too overly thrilled about. Correct me if I'm wrong, if there's any artists in the room today, but this basically will create an image or a picture from a text command. So I put here on the screen an example of a robotic dove. So the prompt was basically robotic dove, and this is what it created. So it's pretty remarkable what this tool can do. Midjourney is being used right now by a lot of content marketing professionals, a lot of digital marketing professionals. And again, it's one of those generative AI tools. So Midjourney basically creates artwork where there was, you know, not that artwork, that artwork did not exist before, right? So using commands, using prompts, it can create works of art that are unique to your use. So this comes in handy if you are running out of stock images, you're running out of pictures, you don't know what else to include, you know you need those high quality visuals for your content marketing posts and your content marketing campaigns, but sometimes it's hard to find what you're looking for. Midjourney can be a good option worth exploring. Now, I would say Midjourney is a little bit more complex of a tool than, say, ChatGPT or Grammarly, and I'll tell you why. Midjourney is accessible through a sort of a separate program called Discord, and you would set up an account and you would use this Discord tool to join a room within the community, the online community, and then use some prompts and commands to ask the tool for a particular type of image that you're looking for. So it takes a little bit more getting used to, a little bit more technical know-how. Certainly it's doable. You don't need to be an IT person. You don't need to be a technical wizard or know how to write code or anything like that to use it. But I would say it might not be the best tool to start out with. However, folks in the industry, of all the image, the generative AI image tools out there right now, I'm hearing that Midjourney is producing the best quality that most people are pretty happy with. So there may be fees associated with this one. This is what the tool looks like sort of on the inside. I took a screenshot when I was working in it yesterday. So you can see, you know, it's a bit more of a complex tool. You'll want to orient yourself a little bit. On the left-hand navigation bar, you'll see some different tools that you'll need to explore and some sort of rooms, as they call them. Newcomer rooms are places where a new person who's just joined Midjourney might start out. So you'll type in what you're looking for, and the bot will send you 4 images in about a minute. So it's pretty fast in terms of how it can create content for you. Again, these are images and they're copyright free. So you can use them in your campaigns. You can use them on social media. You can use them on your websites. And you don't have to give credit to anyone legally as of now. So Midjourney is that image creation AI tool that a lot of marketers are pretty excited about at the moment. Here's an example of a sort of description that someone gave Midjourney the other day. They asked it to create a group of people working on a cooperative farm. In the middle of the group is a mixed race person talking, et cetera, et cetera. And it says, make the image painterly. So that means sort of make it look like a painting. So that's an example of a very specific prompt that someone used on Midjourney. And as you can see here, I've included the image that it created. That's pretty impressive, right? It's created in like 60 seconds using that particular prompt. So the more specific you can get, the better. And you'll want to experiment and play around with it a little bit first. I suggest doing that when you have a bit of downtime. And, you know, give it as much information as you can to get the best possible output. So Midjourney, pretty cool. So AI tips and best practices. Well, again, you're going to want to experiment and familiarize yourself with all of these tools, no matter which one you choose to use. They all have different capabilities. They all have their limitations. Everything you ask it for is not going to be, you know, maybe perfect, but that's okay. You can iterate, you can refine the conversation and guide the conversation. Ask it again, give it some feedback, and keep going. Any examples or background details are always useful when you're using any generative AI tool. And again, you're training the tool. You're training it like a personal assistant, helping it to understand and have more context, more background to deliver the best possible output. Now, because there are so many AI tools out there, it's going to take a bit of work to find the best one. And you can Google best AI tools for marketers. And I can tell you that each website that you land on is going to have a completely different list. So there's no real consensus out there as to which ones are best. Sometimes it is a matter of preference, but the ones that I've shown to you today are certainly some of the more popular ones and some of the more commonly used AI tools across any sector. So there are considerations. Budget is a big one. Obviously, some tools are free. Some tools have a cost associated with them. So that's a factor, as well as, you know, the compatibility with other tools you may be using and how much customer support is offered. Usually with the paid ones, you're going to get a little more in the way of customer support. Many of these tools may come with resources, tutorials, if there are training programs available. Even YouTube videos sometimes can be useful to help you to learn how to get the most out of these tools. And if you're implementing AI tools in your organization, in your staff, then it is going to require probably an investment of at least some time and training to learn how to use those tools effectively. I want everyone on this call and everyone who's watching this to understand that there are risks associated with any artificial intelligence tools. Please don't give it or input any sensitive information. Don't upload your customer data. Don't give it like your credit card number. Don't give it any sort of private information, because in my opinion, it's better to be on the safe side, particularly when it comes to personal and corporate data. But you also want to make sure that everything you input is in compliance with relevant regulations. And also, because AI tools are sort of used, they gather information and they use that information to feed their algorithms. You just want to make sure that your data is protected. I will say with the enterprise version of ChatGPT, they are saying, OpenAI, the organization behind it, is saying that the security and the data privacy features are heightened. So with that enterprise version, you are supposedly getting more in the way of data privacy. So So they are sort of aware of that and working on it. I'm of the opinion that it's, you can never be too careful. So just be mindful of the data you're entering into these tools. Of course, there are the risks of inaccuracy. If you've used ChatGPT, you'll know some of what it gives you is just, it's not true. It's not correct. The tool made a mistake, and that's often the case. So, as I said before, be very mindful of the content that has been created with AI tools. You'll need to proofread it. You'll need to fact check it. You'll need to make sure that it is accurate and correct before you publish it. AI tools can have bias. There's a lot of articles online about this. So be careful with that. It's something to be mindful and something worth exploring a little bit more. Sometimes the content that it gives you can be a little bit homogenous. So that means if you're giving it a similar prompt, let's say, than another organization in the similar space to you, what you guys might both get can be pretty similar. So just make sure that, you are putting your own spin on the content that it produces with ChatGPT in particular. And you'll want to make sure that it is safe and accurate. Again, with the data privacy, it's very, very important that nothing too private or any personal data is not inputted into these tools. So a few key takeaways from today: writing effective prompts, it does take practice. So don't be discouraged if you try it and then you're not getting what you want. Make sure you keep training the tool and giving it more information if you can. Everything that it puts out must be proofread, and keep informed of the changes and advancements. Like I said, these tools are constantly being updated, constantly being enhanced. The AI industry is changing very rapidly. Development is happening at a very rapid speed. And when I deliver workshops and corporate training on artificial intelligence and marketing, there's always something new to talk about. So follow along. You can learn a lot on LinkedIn as well. And in the news, there's lots of developments happening in this exciting sector. And I think the best marketers, honestly, are the ones who just keep exploring and they keep experimenting. And sometimes that's the best way to learn. So thank you, everyone, for listening. I'm going to turn it over to Chris, who's going to tell you a little bit more about the marketing programs here at McMaster Continuing Education.
Thank you again, Emily. We're so lucky to have you as an instructor, as part of our program committee, and as a subject matter expert. So thank you. I'll be sharing some information about our 100% online marketing programs that we've built with our subject matter experts like Emily here as part of McMaster Continuing Education. First is our digital marketing program. Here's an overview of the digital marketing program at McMaster Continuing Ed. We offer a 100% online certificate in digital marketing. Makes sense considering the subject matter. The certificate program requires you to complete 5 core courses. There are so many great courses to choose from within the digital marketing program that discuss digital marketing strategy, digital content strategy, that one newly revised by Emily herself, and search engine optimization, search engine marketing, just to name a few. Our instructors are experts, as you can see, that are currently working in the field, so you can rest assured you're learning from the best of the best. Through this program, you'll learn the latest digital marketing trends, applications, platforms, and best practices, how to utilize marketing theories and the latest digital marketing tools to create results-driven strategies, the latest techniques and practices in website, mobile, social media, search engine, display, and new media management. successful search engine marketing optimization tactics and creative content strategies, and effective digital data metrics and measurements. So here's a look at our digital marketing program. And you can find out more on our website. The next set of classes start in January. So this is a good time to start planning and securing a spot in one of these courses. The next program that I'm going to talk to you about is our marketing program. And this program was designed in association with the DeGroot School of Business here at McMaster to help professionals gain and enhance in-demand skills to succeed in the marketing profession. There are three marketing program pathways to choose from. You can pursue a certificate in marketing, which only requires 5 courses. You can add a few more courses and take the diploma route, or you can kind of mix the best of both worlds and go all the way, get a diploma in marketing with a digital marketing concentration. Again, all of our programs are delivered in 100% online format so that it meets your needs, your schedule, your learning preferences. You'll go through the material with everybody, but you'll have the ability to work when is convenient for you, right? What we call asynchronously. Our marketing program is offered in a flexible online format designed to meet your needs. You'll learn how to leverage research to identify consumer needs and promotional positioning. You'll learn how to develop and execute strategic marketing plans, to communicate ideas, marketing plans, audits, analysis, and tactics, to conduct market research, analyze buyer behavior, complete segmentation, and to analyze marketing metrics and campaign results. And again, like with our digital marketing program, you can learn more about this program and course offerings by visiting our website. I want to thank all of you for joining us, and I hope you found the session useful and informative. I, like Emily, am involved in this space day to day, and I know I learned something from today's webinar, so I'm sure you did too. We look forward to connecting with you soon.
Thank you. Have a great day.